Hi guys, welcome back to FPL Weekly. This is our Game Week 10 preview and today we'll be talking about the player fitness news as well as a hot topic that is Salah Dilemma. And we have the two regular captain choices and gamble picks for you. So let's begin. So firstly, let's start with the fitness news and some injury news as well. So the first big news is that Salah is back. He was tested positive for COVID, but now he's back and he played in the Champions League game for the first 60 minutes only. Mane played the whole game while Robertson also was rested and played only for 30 minutes. But they did lose that game, but still their main big players were rested. So they will probably start again. And talking about Chelsea, so Werner and Chilwell played the whole 90 minutes. So I guess those two are playing all the games and a rest can be near, and ZH but was rested and only played for 15 minutes. And for Manchester United, Bruno is in actually a red hot form, and he played scored two goals. Rashford scored the penalty as well. They both were substituted at 60 minutes, so they are likely going to start against Southampton as well, because those two are the main attacking outlets for Manchester United right now. And talking about City, so Aguero is back from his injury. He came on as a substitute for the last 10 minutes in the Champions League game. Sterling also fresh from a break. Actually, he was rested in the Premier League game. He played for 75 minutes. And KDB was rested. So KDB is a short starter in the next game, I think, if we can beat the Pep Roulette. So yeah. Talking about Callum Wilson. So Callum Wilson was injured, but now he's fit again and will play in Game Week 10 against Crystal Palace. And talking about Crystal Palace, so Zaha did not play in Game Week 9 because he tested positive, and he won't be available for Game Week 10 as well because he is still isolating. And another big news is that the goalkeeper, Burnley goalkeeper Nick Pope, he is out for Game Week 10 after getting a blow on the head in Game Week 9. So yeah, those were some of the big news, and I think we have covered all the press conferences that has happened till now, and these are the news that will be helpful in FPL for you. So yeah, let's go on to our next topic, that is our hot topic, Salah Dilemma. So yeah, talking about Salah, so he did not play in Game Week 9, but he was tested positive for COVID, and I had an option to keep him on the bench. Actually, everyone had an option to keep him on their bench, but I did substitute, take out him for Bruno, and Bruno got me 11 points and he was my captain as well. What did you do with him, Mohit?
Yeah, I had Salah in my team and I have kept him. He was on the bench and he's now back against Brighton. So I'm hoping he does well. In fact, he will also be my captain choice. So he was hoping Salah does well. I mean, a lot of people have sold him. But the fixtures are still good, and in terms of Salah ownership, this could be a differential. Salah has been known to have really high ownership over the years, but looking at the ownership right now, it could be a differential as far as Salah is concerned.
Actually, but looking at my midfield, so I brought in Bruno, and Bruno has been performing really well. But if I have to get Salah in, I don't think I will remove Bruno as soon as possible, because I have Sterling as well. And Sterling, I think, has the better next two fixtures compared to Salah, because Sterling is facing Burnley and Fulham in his next two games. And Salah is facing Brighton and Wolves. So Brighton, stats wise, they have a really good defense, but they haven't been performing. And Wolves, I think they are one of the best defense in the Premier League till now. So I think Salah will be facing a tough opponents, and I will keep Sterling for the next two games and wait for Salah to, you know, get back to his own. So what about Noom? What are you doing with Salah? Do you have him, or are you removing him? Are you getting him? What are you doing?
So yeah, Chirag. So the last game week, I kept Salah. I didn't have any options. Like, I had a Jorginho on the bench, but as you know, he's not in favor. Since CH and all are coming for Chelsea, so I kept him. I kept him for 0 points. in the team, and I even had Zaha in the team. So I kept him. So I'm hoping that he'll play against Brighton, and so he is back against fit for the game. So I guess he's good captaincy option, like Mohit said. So now I'm considering a captain option for this game week. So let's see. So other than that, if our people if you have made a good transfer last game, if someone has done that, then it's good enough. Like you have somebody like Bruno or KDB in your team, because their coming fixtures are good. So it's like you can compare it better than Liverpool with their defense missing. So like in the Champions League game, they did suffer because of that. And then yeah, so I guess it's good enough if you have got in a good player who's performing like Bruno, or you have KDB or like Sterling, so it's good. Then you don't have to worry about Salah that much in the coming game week.
Exactly. So now I don't have Salah, but yeah, I'm also thinking of getting in Mane, if not Salah. So yeah, go on, Mohit.
Yeah, I mean, if you're going for a short-term strategy, it's perfect actually. Like you mentioned, Liverpool have Wolves. And there are a lot of premium midfielders, like Noam said, Sterling, KDB, you could get Fernandes, like you have done, Chirag. There are a lot of premium midfielders who are either doing really well or have really good fixtures. Or you could go for the premium strikers. Jamie Vardy has some really good short-term fixtures. Or Harry Kane, who Kane De Bruyne, as you call him. So there are a lot of options. So if you're going for the short-term strategy and trying to move around a premium asset, it is a very good strategy.
Yeah, exactly. That is my thinking. And I forgot to mention Son as well. So Son has some tough fixtures, but I think he's fixture proof. And if I want to take a punt, and I like Son very much, like you said, with Kane De Bruyne, I like Son as well. So we even call him Sonaldo. So, I'm even thinking about getting him in as well. So let's see, but I am not making a transfer till now for this week. I think my team is set. So I'll just wait and watch this game week and do a transfer or two transfers next week when I have 2-3 transfers. So yeah, that is what we think about Salah and what you should do as well. So let's go on to our next topic. That is the captain picks for game week 10. So yeah, Mohit, who are your captains for Game Week 10? Who are you selecting or choosing as a captain?
So my captain pick most likely will be Salah, like I said. The safest captain pick. The other options I have right now in my team are Sterling and KDB. KDB and Sterling, but then Man City aren't really, I mean, as far as I am concerned, they aren't in that good of a form. While Salah, He is still, with all the people transferring him out, I don't know why they are doing it. Like Chirag, the short-term strategy is good, yeah. But he still is the fourth highest scoring FPL player. And even that after missing one game. So yeah, Salah is the safe pick. But then I also have I am thinking of going for DCL, who's playing against Leeds. Leeds have given up 4 goals in 3 of their matches. They've given up 3 goals in one match, and this within a 9 game week period. I mean, that is absolutely insane. If Everton managed to do that, it could be a haul, and getting a captain there, insane. But then Leeds are a little, I'm not really sure how Leeds will do. They've also kept really good clean sheets against tough opponents. They gave a tough fight to City, so it's dicey, but then Salah might be my pick. It's a safe option, and I guess I'll go for the safe option.
Yeah, I think to sum up to that, Leeds is the most entertaining and unpredictable team currently in the Premier League, I guess. So yeah, talking about Noom's captain picks. So Noom, who are your captain picks for Game Week 10?
So yeah, so my captain picks are like almost same as Mohit. So I have DCL in the team, and I have Salah in the team. So most likely I'm leaning towards Salah, because I feel like he can get a good point haul. But then let's see, like last game week I made my captain choice at the end. I had DCL till the end of the week, and I changed my captain to Grealish, and then all of y'all know what happened. So yeah, so then I have DCL and Salah. But other than that, if you're looking for another captain choice, you can go KDB if you have KDB in your team.
they are playing Burnley, and Burnley are missing out on their main goalkeeper. And they had this season, they are struggling defensively as well. So if you have KDB, you can go for him. And then the other guy I'm looking out for is Vardy. So if you have Vardy in your team, they have a good fixture as well. Last four game weeks, he has got 8 shots on target. Only, I guess he's only behind Bamford on that ranking. And so these two guys are a good captain choice for this game week, considering their game and their form.
Yeah, actually, I think Vardy is a great shout, because Vardy against Fulham, I think he can score a lot of goals, and I'm finding a way to get him in my team, but I don't think I'll be removing Kane or DCL or even Bamford, because I think those three are the best forwards currently, talking about the budget and as well as performance-wise. So yeah, but my captain pick for Game Week 10 from my team, I think Bruno is the go-to option, because currently he's in red-hot form. And talking about away games, so Bruno has a great record in away games this season. And leaving the penalties aside, he has created the most number of chances in the league this season, even more than KDB. So I think he is a great option. Currently he's in red-hot form, because he also got 2 goals in the Champions League. So yeah, Bruno is my captain pick. And most likely I'll keep the armband on Bruno only. So yeah, talking about our next topic, so our next topic is gamble picks. So gamble is someone who, you know, is in less than 5% of the teams and can get you a lot of points and, you know, take you to the top of the mini leagues if he performs well and no one hasn't. So yeah, who are your gamble picks, Mohit?
Yeah, my first gamble pick is Gabriel Jesus. He's only in 1.3% of the team, and it's surprising how a Man City striker is only in 1.3% of the team. Yes, he could see some rotation with Aguero, but then I think because Aguero had been recently injured, and then he played, he'd gotten better, and then he played in the match and again got the injury. Guardiola might be a little careful with him. So Jesus could see some really some extended minutes, and if you look at his XG per 90, it's actually higher than Sterling. And he's been in really good. We saw the goal that he scored against Liverpool. So he's full of confidence. That is my first gamble pick, Gabriel Jesus. And the second one is Harvey Barnes. Like you mentioned, Leicester have some really good fixtures, and Harvey Barnes, of course, we've seen him being explosive. I had him last time when he got the 17 or 18 point haul. I mean, I remember that, and if he could do that again, it would be really crazy. So yeah, the good fixture against Fulham seems to be a good time to bring him in.
Yeah, so actually talking about Manchester City attackers, so Sterling is also in less than 5% of the teams, and he is my gamble pick, because I have kept him in my FPL team from game week 3. I have shown a lot of patience in him, and I think this is the game week which kickstarts, you know, Manchester City's season. Because looking at history, in the last 4 Premier League games, Manchester City has scored 15 goals against Burnley. So, you know, this is a fixture where Manchester City love to score goals, and with Pope also out, I think Pope went out because he didn't want to, you know, degrade his record against City more. So that's why he's not playing in game week 10 as well. So yeah, with Aguero also back and all other attacking options available, I think City will play in full form now against Burnley, and Sterling can get a lot of points. Who are your gamble picks, Noom?
So yeah, Chira, my gamble pick for game week 10, the first one I would like to speak about is Richarlison. So after him coming back, if you watched the last game against Fulham, they played quite well. You know, they conceded 2 goals, but attacking wise they were quite good. They got a lot of chances. In the first half they were pretty good. And the other reason is Richarlison, they are playing Leeds, and Leeds leaves a lot of space behind. And once they concede the first goal, I see, like, you know, they struggle to, you know, come back in the game. And the other team is good at counter attacking wise, and you know, they are good attackers up front. Leeds struggle. So I guess if Everton plays at their best, with James there and DCL there, Richarlison could get some points on board. and then he's also on penalties, so hopefully you can take a punt on him if you have the budget and you want to get somebody, you know, who's not in lot of the teams. And the other one is Aguero. So yeah, but there is the risk of rotation and his chances highly less since Jesus has been playing quite well as well. But then if he gets a chance, last season he had a good record against teams below the top six. So hopefully if he is in and if you have the budget, you want to take the risk and he could pay off for you.
Yeah, actually Aguero is also in similar as Jesus. He is also in 1.3% of the teams only. So there are three City attackers which are in less than 5% of the teams, and those are our gamble picks as well. So we are really punting on City to score a lot of goals against Burnley this week. So let's see what happens, who scores the goals. And stay tuned guys and keep watching our show. Do like, share and subscribe as well. Thank you.